As promised, here's Coach postgame with the media.
Hey, Steve, I asked you pregame about their three-point shooting and the problems it poses. You held them to 35%. I'm just curious what you thought of your three-point defense tonight, especially down the stretch.
It was a lot better in the final three quarters. You know, we struggled defensively in the first quarter. I thought we were a little indecisive. Made too many errors, mental errors. But, you know, the last three quarters, 25, 25, 21 points was very good. And we kept telling them during the game, like, well, our defense is getting better. Stick with it. Keep getting better. And they did. They did a great job. They battled. They fought. Our rebounding got better. And we got the stops.
Christian Winfield, New York Daily News.
Coach, it just seems to be a theme somewhat this season. You know, guys go down for whatever reason. Guys are in and out of the lineup for whatever reason. But you guys find a way to stay consistent in what you guys are trying to do. Can you just talk about how you guys have gotten to this point? Because it seemed like it wasn't like that earlier in the season, and now you guys are kind of like on a string and playing for each other.
I mean, I think it's time, growth, you know, familiarity. You know, we have a common experience, and we have a bunch of guys that are willing to come in and fight for the group and play together and play the right way and play selfless basketball. So, you know, proud of all the guys that have stepped in to bigger roles while guys are out. We've formed, you know, a great cohesion, I think. And tonight it really came down to just fighting and wanting it. They're a tough team to guard. And we told them, you just got to stick with it and keep fighting and good things happen.
Tom Dowd, BrooklynNets.com.
See, this probably kind of falls in the same category, you know, in terms of winning these games, being on demand a little bit. But you've had a bunch of these games since the break. It really came down to it in the fourth quarter. And just, you know, how significant have you seen this team develop in those situations over the last couple of weeks?
Yeah, I think, you know, we're getting more familiar with situations at the end of games. You know, most importantly, we got the stops, gave us separation. You know, that group that was in there when James was out was great. You know, took it up, I can't remember what it was, 7-8 point lead. And then James came in and, we got the stops more so than the baskets in a way. We were able to get stops and rebounds when it counted, and then we were able to take care of the situations down the stretch. So always difficult, you know, when a team needs to get a steal or try to deny the ball inbounds, some of those scenarios can be tricky, and we took care of it tonight.
Brian Lewis, New York Post.
Steve, you talked about the defense improving as you went on. Obviously, Kanter is a load in there and was tough at times for Nick. But how much did Nick's mobility and ability to switch, how much did that help you going down the stretch in the second half?
Yeah, Nick was huge. You know, he's such a versatile player defensively with his length and athleticism, his mobility. You know, he can guard pretty much 1 through 5. So, yeah, he's going to struggle at times on the glass. But a lot of that was more so coming out of rotations and stuff. So, you know, he's a threat offensively around the basket. And, you know, he's developing every day. So proud of him. His defensive effort is outstanding and very valuable to us.
Steve Lichtenstein, WFAN.
Hi, Steve. Most fans know Blake Griffin as your all-star scorer. Can you describe the impact that he's having with hustle plays, setting screens, taking charges?
Yeah, I mean, Blake's experience and intelligence are really important. You know, he still, you know, has the ability to play make and make threes, rebound, post up smaller players. So it's not that he's just a hustle player now, but he's willing to dive on the floor. He's already taken a few charges, but that intelligence and experience is adding to our group. And as he continues to get more familiarity with the group and the way we play, he's going to be more valuable as well.
We'll go back to Alex Schiffer.
Hey, Steve, I got two for you. Just as Steve just said, you got good minutes from Blake tonight. Do you expect him to play tomorrow as you guys try to ramp him up, or you might rest him just because he's still getting into shape?
We'll see. You know, we'll see how he feels tomorrow. You know, it's a little tricky with that. You know, we don't want to put him in a dangerous position with his knee. So we'll evaluate it tomorrow and see where he is and how far along he is in his adaptation process and make a decision tomorrow.
Gotcha. And my second one, you didn't need to sign Jesus tonight, as you said pregame, but you guys did sign Alize Johnson. Just what does he give you guys? And do you have an idea when he'll be able to join you?
I think tomorrow is what I hear. So, we'll see when he gets here, and look forward to meeting him.
Thanks, Coach, for your time.
Thank you, Steve.
Good night.